What's all the buzz about? Bees and honey, up next. Hi, I'm Jean Marie Appleby with Local Harvest Eating Fresh, and today I'm in New Smyrna Beach, Florida, learning all about bees. What can we do to promote bee health and to attract bees to our garden to increase pollination? Let's find out.
Hi, I'm Doug McInnes. I'm the former owner of Tropical Blossom Honey Company. Today I'm really talking more about bees. We sold our company in 2015. But we have a long history in beekeeping and beekeeping families here in Florida. My dad and mom started the company in 1940.
My parents came down from West Virginia in 1937. My dad learned beekeeping from his great uncle and my great uncle. And he would have hives in the orange groves, which were all around here, including very nearby here. To make orange blossom honey and to help pollinate the citrus trees. So he would bring in the orange blossom honey, my mother would pack it into jars, and then they brought it into town to sell.
And I've never known a time when more people are asking me, what can I do for the bees? They've heard or read or seen articles about the loss of bees, and everyone is more concerned than I've ever known in my life.
My name is Marlon Atherin. I'm a native here of New Smyrna Beach, which there's not many of us here. I'm also a master beekeeper certified by the University of Florida's Department of Apiary, their Honeybee Extension Laboratory. We're currently out in Corbin Park Road, just west of downtown New Smyrna, and I've been beekeeping for probably about 11 years, and I've turned my property into basically a giant bee yard. The interest part was, I think, an offshoot of being interested in one, history, and two, nature. I just thought it was pretty cool. Like a lot of things we tend to do in life, I bought hives having no idea what I was doing and had no equipment, so I got the bees, so I kind of did it backwards. Where nowadays there's so much information out there, especially on the internet, with bee clubs like we have one in the county with the beekeepers of Volusia County, that it's much easier now than it used to be. Before, you just read old books written up north and then tried to figure it out. Basically, as a master beekeeper, I am an extension of their honeybee laboratory. So basically, your University of Florida Agriculture Extension offices, like the one out on in Deland on 44, they refer phone calls to me that would normally get referred to the University of Florida. And then I handle those things so the Honeybee Extension Laboratory can do what they do as far as doing the research to make overall beekeeping easier and better for the hobbyist and commercial beekeepers. I mean, a beehive is nothing more than basically a dog or a cat with no skin. It does the same thing they do. It consumes, it moves, it reproduces, it does all these things, and yes, it thinks. It communicates within itself, just like our cells do with the electrical system and the nervous system. The hive is a living organism. It makes decisions. No single bee in the hive does anything on its own. It's the group that, you know, does the decision making. At certain times during a bee's lifespan, which is about 43 days for a worker bee in the summertime, they go through a cycle of tasks, everything from as soon as they're born, they turn around and clean out the cell they were just born in, all the way to mortuary bee jobs. Their job is to take dead bodies out, making comb, processing honey, taking care of the queen, defending the entrance. And then at about 21 days, they graduate to be the bees you see out on the flowers. Those are the foragers, collecting water, propolis, pollen, nectar. They're like the senior citizens. They also tend to be the grumpier bees.
And then the thing that we love about bees is that they produce honey. And you are producing some really wonderful honey. Tell me how, what that process is like, how it works.
Right now, saw palmetto is blooming really hard. So the bees are out and they're collecting nectar from saw palmetto. That worker that we talked about, the senior citizen, they fly back, land on the doorstep. There's a bee right inside the door to offload her, division of labor. She passes that nectar on to a bee that hasn't quite become a field bee. Then that bee goes up and starts processing that nectar into honey. As a beekeeper, depending on your perspective, I get to steal it. Now, why do bees store extra honey? Well, the species plural that we use are mostly all from Europe. They had to evolve to produce food to survive winter. I go in and take the frames out that are almost all sealed, because when the honey's ripened, it's the proper water content. The bees like what they see. They'll seal each cell with wax, so it becomes basically a little storage compartment. And then take them into my honey house, slice the outer layer off, and then put those into my extractor and just basically remove the honey from the comb right through and into a jar. The floral content is everything. Either singularly or combinations of different floral contents will change color, definitely flavor, consistency, water content, sugar content, and it's just amazing the varieties. I think there's about 64 different varieties of honey you can get just here in Florida. So around the world, it's amazing. And some of the honeys are absolutely amazing. Oh, when you start mixing different floral contents, it's just like, you know, you're mixing sauces when you're cooking. Okay, this is good, that's good, but put them together and wow, it's amazing.
We talked a little bit about beekeeping. It's not as easy as it may seem. You can see how much devotion Marlon puts into the art and craft of beekeeping. Not everyone should perhaps be a beekeeper, but you can produce a little native bee hotel in your yard. And it's as simple, you can see in this one, which is kind of fancy, but you can see these little tubes. And what we've done here is just make little PVC tubes and put inside them little bamboo tubes that allow native pollinators to come in. You're going to want to seal them up at the end with chewing gum or caulk or something, and just hang them in your yard. You may see these trucks around your neighborhood with lawn services that are doing spraying. Remember that they may be killing the cinch bugs and the other pests in your lawn, but they're killing a lot more also. And this may be something that, it may be time that you decide, I'm giving up spraying in my lawn to do these things. Look around your yard. There's a lot of native plants that are blooming. In the springtime now, we have saw palmetto. We have gallberry, which is a native holly. They're both providing huge nectar sources. We have wildflowers like Spanish needle, that little shrubby daisy-like weed that grows in your yard. That's providing excellent pollen and nectar for all the pollinators in your yard. There's just these little tiny things you can do when you look around your yard to make it more attractive. Over 30% of our food supply is dependent on honeybee pollination. Just hundreds and hundreds of the things you take for granted that you buy at the grocery store, we would not have without honeybees. And if you do decide to get into beekeeping, join a beekeeping club. Almost every county in Florida has a beekeeping club that are very active today. And being part of this community, it's much better than reading from a book how to become a beekeeper. You can learn from people like Marlon about the secrets and the little tips that'll help you on your way. And share equipment, you know, share some of the stories you've had within the hive. And it's just a wonderful community as well. So join that beekeeping club. You can find out from your local extension agency where the beekeeping clubs are meeting in your county.
And this is what it's all about, liquid, gold, sweet, sticky honey. Oh my goodness, look at that. Evan, look.
That's perfect. You like that? My eyes.
I know you can't stand it. Come over here. Well, take the honey.
Let me take that.
Don't make a mess.
Mm. Yes.
Oh, by the way, this is my assistant, Yvanne Magoulas. She's going to be helping me tonight. She's the official taster, but tonight she has to, you know, work for a living, so.
You're not going to make me cook on the show, are you?
Gosh, no, then I'd have to eat it. You're not going to force me to do that.
We're not going
You're
there.
You're just tasting, okay?
All right.
But tonight, everything we're making is with fresh farm honey. And we're also using fresh produce and different things that we picked up from the farms. So it'll be a fun night. Let's talk about honey a little bit. Very, very interesting item. We know that we raise a lot of honey here in Florida, but you know, honey has been found in the pyramids, and the honey there is still good. That's over 3,000 years ago. It's amazing how a honey can store forever. It doesn't go bad. The other thing about honey, which is interesting, is the fact that you can take it and it's sterile. It's good for cuts and different things. Now, in World War I, when they didn't have antibiotics, what they would do is they would wrap the wounds up with honey. And they still do a little bit of that today. Your grandmother will come up and say, come here, you got a little sore in your mouth. Put some honey in there. And you go, oh, sure, right. But it does work. You're laughing, right? Did your grandmother do that too?
Yes, we use a lot of honey for medicinal purposes.
Well, let me show you. One other thing the ancient Greeks liked to do was the fact that when you came into their home, they always gave you something sweet. Now, what happened with that is they would take honey and almonds, something sweet. That was traditional. So I'm going to do something traditional, but I'm going to do it a little bit bigger because I got a bigger group here. So we're making a fresh fruit tray. And I'm going to put it, what I've done is I've cut up fresh strawberries. Boy, look at these strawberries. Aren't they gorgeous?
They're
huge. That's that Plant City fresh strawberry. I have kiwi, oranges, and I have some raspberries in there. And what I've done, I've taken this fresh, beautiful cone of honey. Isn't that, what, do you want to grab it?
I want to taste that.
I was afraid of that. Okay, here we go. And here it is right here. And I got to put this down. Why don't you come over? Because I want to drip honey all over everything.
Okay, ooh, it's sticky.
You going to eat that?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to eat the whole thing.
No, you can't eat the whole thing. Mm-hmm.
This piece is good.
Isn't this beautiful? Look at that honey. That honeycomb has wax on the outside. That's that natural wax. You can eat that.
It's chewy.
It's chewy. It really tastes good, doesn't
Very
it?
Very tasty.
Oh, man, I just love honeycomb. Now, what I've done is I took the honeycomb and I mixed it in to the platter. Doesn't that look beautiful?
Gives it a nice shine.
Right, and it's different. So when you have friends coming over and they're looking at this, they'll say, wow, what's that? That's honeycomb. They can say, look at that platter. Now, let me show you some. Since we got this fruit out, let me show you a little something about fruit. You have an orange over there?
Here's an orange.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Let me do something here real quick, because I got this big sticky knife, and I don't want to get it all over the place here. I should have used a different knife. That's all your fault, making me cut that darn honeycomb. Okay. Now, a lot of people don't know how to cut an orange. They think they do, but what you do is you cut the edge off, both of them. I'm gonna make it real easy for you. So you take this and you just cut in circles. Do you see that?
Yes.
You can come over here and watch.
I think I could probably
do that. As long as you don't touch my knife.
I don't wanna touch it. I'm afraid I'd cut myself.
I'm the one with a knife. You'd make me cut myself. Now we can save these if we want, but we're not going to. We could zest them in our puddings and desserts. Okay, I take it. Trim it up. Now, there's the orange. It's ready to go. You can do a couple things with this. You can take it and cut it in half, and then you can just take slices off of it like that. Isn't that special? Yeah, I know. You want the orange, too. Well, you're the taste. See
Tasting.
How that comes off real nice? And when you cut off, the center is still there. You don't eat that. Mm-hmm. We'll just put that fruit right on there, and that's the way you cut an orange. Now, if you want to make it more decorative, just cut across. Just like this. Isn't that nice? You get this nice little cut
nice
like
medallion.
That. And it's easy. You could actually do this, I think. I mean, you'd have to practice a little bit. I'll get you one of those children's knives.
Can I get a
it's plastic
knife?
So you don't have to cut yourself. So here we go. And we do some more. And we're going to finish it up right there. Okay. Now, let's take a look at this platter, okay? Isn't this beautiful? I just love this. I'd like to see what this looks like on TV. I bet it's just gorgeous. You're in there looking at this. Do you like that?
I like it a lot.
I like it a lot, too. We're going to put this right over here right now. So we're going to play around with a few other things. And as I said, tonight we're going to be dealing with honey, and we're going to make a few different things from honey. Right now, we're going to take and make this huge salad. Okay, you want to bring that over here? Jeannie has been telling me all about this hydroponic lettuce and everything, so I went out and got some, okay? You happy, Jeannie? There it is. Hydroponic, fresh, leafy, and that beautiful, what do you call this?
Butter lettuce?
Butter lettuce, you win. Okay. Now, here's the part you don't eat, right?
No, I'm not eating it.
Well, what you do is you just tear that part right out. Oh, comes right off. Isn't that amazing? Look, the leaves just came apart. So we take it out again. There it is, buttered lettuce. Now, we can do a couple things with this if we want. We can take it and just tear it with our hands. That's the old traditional way. If you had gloves on, I'd let you do it, but I'm not going to let you do that.
Oh, too bad. So I'm gonna...
You like tearing lettuce? Let me tell you something. It's very important that when you wash vegetables at home, wash them real good, and then pat it dry with a paper towel or something like that. You know, years ago, they didn't have stainless steel knives. So when you cut salads, they would turn brown because they use those galvanized knives. Mm-hmm. They actually came up with a wood knife, and that's what you would cut salad with. And that worked out pretty good. The other way, they also had animal bone knives and things like that. They would actually use those. It was about the 1918 they came out with stainless steel, and that's when they came out with the first stainless steel knife. You could actually cut the salad, and it wouldn't turn brown on you. Until then, a lot of people just had to pull it apart with their hands. How are we doing, okay? Does that pass your test?
That's a good start for me.
Good start, yeah, thanks a lot. Okay, now we need some tomatoes, and we have some of these hydroponics again. I tell you what, fresh is so much better. You know, if you, here, you want one? I know you like tomatoes, okay? How's that?
Those are very tasty, I like those.
Tasty, they're fantastic.
Fantastic.
Now the salad's starting to take shape. Mm-hmm. All right, I'll give you that back. Okay, and I have some cucumber. This is that English cucumber.
I need to
what
taste
do you want?
It.
You gotta eat everything?
He said I was the official taster.
Thanks a lot. This is English cucumber. It doesn't have quite as many seeds in it. Very tasty. And see, boy, this thing's really starting to take shape, isn't it? Now, the real thing I like about is onion. We have to have an onion. Where's a red onion around here? I saw one
here.
Earlier. You hiding it over there so I can't see it? I'm looking everywhere for it. Okay,
you're gonna
here
have
we
to
go.
Taste this too.
You want to taste? Here, take a bite. No. Now you have the red onion. What I do is I like to thin it, real thin slices. Oh man, like my little Santoku knife. Mm-hmm. It's all-purpose knife. It's pretty neat. That means you can cut anyway. Santoku is kind of way saying you can cut three ways with a knife. That's the term Santoku, or Sandeku. Now, boy, isn't that taking shape? You want an onion here? Be my guest.
Thank you.
I like red onions. Because I think they're sweeter, and I think they really have a good taste when you put them in salads. Okay, we're going to put a little bit more on here. Come on, tell me that's not looking it's beautiful.
Colorful and fresh.
Isn't that gorgeous?
It is.
Oh, I just love
that.
What
dressing are we going to make for that?
You're going to make the dressing. What?
No.
Did I just scare you a little bit?
Yeah, you did. Maybe here. That's why all these bowls are here.
All right, give me your bowl over here. What we're going to do is make honey mustard dressing. And it's so simple, it's not even funny. We have mayonnaise, we have mustard, and we have honey. That's all there is to it. What?
Okay.
You don't believe me, do you? Okay, well, you're going to find out real quick. Now, the recipes are on our Facebook page, but it's pretty much equal parts here. We're putting mayonnaise in here. Okay. And then we take some mustard. Mix that in there. I'm not going to do anything. And then the magic ingredient, the honey. Let's see if this works. Ooh, look at that. Now, do you think you can mix this together?
I'll try.
Just don't get it everywhere, okay?
All right.
Stir it up real good, and let's see. You take, here, let me show you. Okay. Take it and scoop it like this. instead of stirring it around in a whip so it doesn't fly everywhere. How we doing?
Okay.
Okay, you're going to have to taste that. I'm not.
I have to make it and taste it?
Yes.
Okay.
Tell me what you think of that.
It needs more mustard.
Does it? Okay, see how easy
and
that
honey.
Was? More mustard and honey?
And honey.
Boy, I'm telling you, you're getting pickered. Picky, picky, picky.
No, not mayonnaise, I said honey.
No more, golly, listen to that. See how nice this is? You can make your own dressing at home. You get, ooh, I got honey everywhere. You go out and buy pre-made honey mustard dressing and you're paying $4 a bottle for it and see what happens. Okay, how we doing? We gotta move along here.
Okay.
All right, taste that, tell me what's going on.
Let me taste it again. That's more like it.
Isn't that good?
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing. Okay, we do that, we're gonna make one more over here. And this is avocado honey. Now what I did here is I mashed up fresh avocado, and I'm gonna put this in here. Nice avocado, oh, look at that, isn't that?
That
I love
good.
Avocado. And we're gonna put some avocado in there, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna put a little bit of mustard in that, not a lot, and we're gonna put some avocado oil. Don't need a lot because it already has it in there. And then we'll pour that in here like that, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add the honey to this. Then you stir that up, and while you're doing that, I'm gonna be doing something else. Excuse me, I'm right, wrong thing here. Okay, so you're doing the avocado. See how simple that one is?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what I did earlier today is I made some hamburgers, and I made a glaze with honey. And this glaze has soy sauce, it has honey in it, and it has a little bit of salt, pepper, and ginger. And what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna cook off little patties like this, which will be real nice. We have some chicken in the oven, in our magic oven, so I use this glaze on thighs and drumsticks. Now everybody goes out there and buys chicken wings, right? Chicken wings are like $3, $4, $5 a pound. You get legs and drumsticks on sale for like 99 cents, $1.99, and they taste great. Well, you're gonna find out. I roasted them in the oven, and I glazed them with this marinade that I just made. And this is what I'm gonna do here too. I'm gonna take these hamburgers. No, you're not cooking them. Get them going in here. And we'll have these very shortly. What do you think so far, Evan?
So far, so good.
So far, thank you, I'm glad you appreciate that. Here we go, we're putting it in our pan. And this pan, oh, here we go. It's starting to sizzle, dizzle. See how, oh, we're doing pretty good over here. Make sure we're cooking away. Can y'all smell that out there? People at home, do you smell it? Tell me. Oh, that, it really does, now they're telling me, it smells good. It better smell good, it's all fresh ground meat. Now, if you have a little special piece of bread, like this focaccia bread, you cut it in half, you can make yourself a little slider.
No, I like that.
That looks pretty good, doesn't it?
Sure.
Got a pan, I'm gonna put it right here.
Oh.
Right now, we need to get into our magic oven and look at what we got in there. Can we put this over there, Evan?
Certainly.
Okay, here we go. We're going to the magic oven, and here it comes. Oh boy, you can't wait till you see this. Okay, here we go. No, get away from my chicken. We're gonna go ahead and put this up over here. Can you hold that?
I'll hold it.
Don't move it. I can't hit a moving target.
Trying to get that burger closer to me.
I noticed that. Let me do something with this real quick. I think I might need to turn this down just a hair. Oh, yeah.
They smell wonderful.
Oh, my goodness gracious, is that ever good. Then I'm gonna put that glaze right on top of it, just like this.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Look at this, right? Look at what we have here.
That's a lot of chicken.
Well, it's a lot of people hungry. They're going to come down to the studio, you know, from watching on TV. And they're coming down. Come on down. There's a traffic jam on Mason Avenue. Oh, look at this. Isn't this nice? I promised this crew and everybody that I would take care of them. I don't think they realized what I was talking about. Look at all these drumsticks and thighs. Isn't that better than wings? Come on, gang. All right, look at this. And now I have that sauce. Okay, just set it down right here. And you know, that's how we cook it up fresh here. You've got to try these dishes we made today, Van, and y'all out there listening.
Thanks for joining us. If you missed any of those steps, you can find the recipes on our Facebook page. There you'll also find links to all the places that we visit. Do what you can to encourage and welcome bees to your garden. Try a few of the things that we shared today, and I promise you, you'll see an increase in yield of vegetables, fruits, and flowers. Or join one of the local beekeeping clubs and become a part of the beekeeping trend. You'll not only enjoy garden pollinators, but also your own fresh honey. And don't forget to get out there and find fresh, grow fresh, eat fresh, and join us next week for Local Harvest.